over the last year, you could drive down Bits Randolph and look over to the side and you would see a fence. You couldn't quite see. They like to hide the dirt from you. But you could see sticking up out of the dirt these red towers, and they've been there for almost a year, drilling hundreds of geothermal wells that are going to go below the new parking facility. And this is going to be the first installation on the East Campus that will supply that brand new East Campus GeoExchange. The importance of the GeoExchange at Princeton is significant in that it could be one of the largest installations of its type yet installed worldwide. We could have close to 2,000 wells being installed. We're also attempting to drill to different levels using novel exchangers. The depth of geothermal systems can range quite a bit. A typical ground source heat pump you might find at someone's house might be only 100 feet deep. It could be up to maybe 500 feet deep. Here on campus, we're drilling wells down to 800 feet in order to maximize the amount of heat we can extract. In my research, we're interested in wells, and we have one test well here that we drilled at 1,300 feet, but we hope to do tests down to 2,000 or 3,000 feet. And in those depths, the earth gets warmer as we go down. So the advantage would be eventually we can drill to a depth where we can just take heat out of the ground at the temperature of, say, 80 to 100 degrees and use it directly. And if we do that, we get 10 times more energy efficiency out of the system. The problem we face is drilling to those depths remains rather expensive. And this is really where being on a university campus with the facilities leaders that are willing and ready to treat the campus a bit like a laboratory, that really make it an extremely important installation that will certainly be demonstrative of what we need to do to address climate change at the scale of campuses moving into the future. I am an eternal optimist in most things, including our ability to address the global challenges we face. We are on campus also expanding our solar installations, incorporating more renewables, thinking about how materials cycle through our campus, how everyday sustainability ethos is built into our pedagogy. And I think all those things have to be part of an optimistic viewpoint. And we have to be bringing in our friends and colleagues too that are outside of academia, not making it seem like this is some idealistic, research-based endeavor, but one that everybody can appreciate and that by engaging in, we're actually improving not just the environment, but also the society around it.